stuff. Everybody's got stuff. Some of the stuff is valuable, some of the stuff is just trash. How do you tell the difference? Here's how you tell the difference. Dr. Laurie Verderame, she's nationally and internationally known art historian, PhD, you know it all. Dr. Laurie, thanks for being here today.
I'm happy to be here, you know that.
We're going to talk oil paintings. What do we need to know if your oil painting is a valuable one or it's just a piece of junk?
You can learn more from the back than you learn from the front. We'll talk about that in a minute. But let's talk about where you're going to put your oil painting. So let's look here behind you. So you've got this oil painting, right? Pretty big, majestic, nice piece, pastoral landscape, you know, not going to offend anybody, nice representational piece. When you look at it, what's the first thing you see?
It's big and slightly crooked on the wall.
Okay, slightly crooked on the wall, but it's on the right wall, okay? It's on the correct wall. You want it on an interior wall. Okay, because exterior walls like near your windows are going to damage that painting over time. So where you hang a painting is just as important as what you hang. Mm. All right, so you're hanging it, you're also hanging it on the right wall, but you've got the wrong return above it. You don't want to ever hang a painting where there's some kind of return or a radiator or an air conditioner or any of that, because temperature and humidity will change and that will help to crack the painting.
I kind of thought that a cracked painting showed that it was old and valuable.
No, it shows that it's damaged. Now, most of these will deteriorate over time because of the way it's actually prepared. There's a piece of canvas, there's gesso or rabbit skin glue, some kind of adhesive that's going to allow the oil paint to stick to the canvas. Without that intermediary glue or adhesion, you basically will not have that pigment stick to the canvas. Now, all of these paintings are going to deteriorate and crack at some point as they age. It's not unlike, you know, wrinkles on my skin, okay? So you have to think about that kind of thing. So people are always looking for signatures. There are lots of paintings that don't have signatures and aren't supposed to be signed.
And that does that cut down their value?
No, it doesn't cut down their value. I've seen like 19th century landscape paintings signed with Sharpie magic markers. People want to give you signatures.
So they'll just write on a painting and it's not even
Yeah, because people want signatures. Ooh, is it a signature? Oh, it must be important. Well, it's not always important. And some very, very valuable paintings don't have any signatures at all because in the 18th century, for example, it was seen as inappropriate for an artist to get marketing information or sign his work as well as get paid for his work.
Look at the back.
Let's
look at the back. Okay. We've got a couple of paintings here. Now, this painting does not have canvas on it. Is that good or bad?
This is an illustration board, which means it's a piece of cardboard with a piece of canvas wrapped around it. This indicates that this piece is younger than your piece. Let's look at the back of your piece. Your piece has telltale signs of being an American painting that's old. Here's the first one. You see the age spot on my face right here? That age spot that's being covered up? That age spot is not unlike this. The older I get, the darker it gets. The older the canvas gets, the darker it gets. So if you have a dark canvas, you're going to have a canvas that's relatively old.
A picture from an oil from the 1950s, is it going to have a dark canvas?
No, it's going to be light, like
when
your hair.
When did they start getting dark?
100 years old.
Okay.
So call it as it becomes an antique. And depending on its conditions, if it's somewhere hot and somewhere cold and somewhere hot and somewhere cold, it's going to darken too.
Is every old painting, old dark canvas painting valuable?
Could be. Depends. Here are some of the factors. You're looking right here at an old canvas, circa 1890 to 1900. You're looking at an old stretcher bar. That's these wooden pieces, not to be confused with the frame. And you're looking at new keys. See these?
Yeah.
These are probably from the 1950s. You see how much lighter they are in wood? You see how much darker this is? This is the 1890 piece. This is the 1950 piece. It's pretty simple.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
So now from the back, the other thing I want you to look for is I want you to look for a canvas that's been stretched, and you can see it right here. The canvas comes around from the front and it's stretched here and it is adhered with nails, not with staples. By the 1950s, they're using the staple gun.
So you look at the back of the painting even before you look at the front to find age.
I do.
Okay.
And every expert like me does.
Okay.
Okay. That is a typical 19th century American painting. Boom. Without looking at anything on the front. We just looked at the back.
Okay. And
okay.
We're just about running out of time.
Okay.
And any kind of a glaze? There's a glaze on the front of this?
There's a glaze on this, which is called Dacmar varnish, which means the artist has basically mixed in with the pigment, they mixed in the varnish. All right. With this one, they painted the painting first and then applied the varnish on top. When it's mixed in, sometimes you're going to get this. This is from heavy smoking. That yellow haze is no different from the nicotine haze on someone's teeth if they're smokers.
Last question.
Yep.
Do you get a painting cleaned?
Don't be overzealous about cleaning. Everybody wants to clean a painting, and it's important that you realize you may actually alter it and devalue it if the cleaning job is not done well. contact your local museum, get a reference for a good conservator or a good cleaner. Who the museum uses is who you should be using.
All right, an oil painting can be trash, it can be treasure.
That's right, you need an expert. DrLoriV.com. Go to our website, send me a picture, I'll tell you what's what.
Okay, DrLoriV, thank you so much. Great information on oil paintings, and I hope you've got one that'll make you millions. We'll see you next time.